Oh, the beeping. Buff God! Let's go! What is going on, everybody? It is time for another Bleach Monday. You already know. We want to get right into it. I know. We're going to get into it. I expect some good things from this episode. I've heard some good things about this episode. So I really just kind of want to kick off into this. My expectations, Kenpachi at the end of the episode maybe, and then a little bit of a training arc throughout this episode in general. So it's going to be fun. Will we get BuffCon? Fingers crossed, at least for BuffCon, you know? So who knows? Let's get into this because I'm really excited. With that being said, if you like these videos, like and subscribe as per usual, and leave a comment in the comment section down below of what you think of this episode in general so I can copy them and use them for my review. Let's get into it, shall we? Isane, what's going on? Is this where he has his letter? We might have to say goodbye. Hopefully not. Fingers crossed. Let's see if you can talk to Central 46 about that. Appointing Kuroko's head captain at Squad 1. Probably from Genryusai here. Back at Karinji's place with the hot springs. Hey, it's those guys. Nice. You failed. Didn't your parents teach you as a kid? You're not supposed to get that up until you finish counting to 200. I don't really think that that's a method taught as a kid, to be fair, but... See, I'm sure that these guys didn't come out until after they... until after? Yeah, they skipped. Damn. Yeah, they just flew past a lot of content, but it's okay. You're healed. No bruises on Ichigo's face, then? If you weren't, that would have killed you. Sheesh, all the fangirls going crazy. Hey, come on, Renji. He's going to get absolutely uppercutted now, isn't he? Ooh. Ooh, take that. There you go. Well, you didn't send me flying. Yo, man's struggling, though. If you can withstand my punch, you're probably alright. Probably because you hurt your hand in the process while hitting Ichigo, isn't it? So, probably not 400% on strength. Glad we get to see that. Yeah, his hands in the sauna, isn't it? Sauna. Springs. Damn, what? They just exploded. God damn. That was close. If we weren't for these protective bathing robes made by Super... Okay. Thanks, Disney, for your subtitles. Those boys were able to soak in Tanjiro's white bone hell and blood bond naked as if it was nothing. Damn, their muscles are like twitching and whatnot. Yeah, over excessive healing, isn't it? There's the bruise. And that punk took my strike. He reflexively struck my fist and fractured it. That's our goat. What's this now? Two lieutenants. Oh, Central 46. Okay. Third seat Ukuba knows how to manage Squad 1, while Lieutenant Issei knows how to handle me. Bro? Now then, may I proceed with the first task as head captain? I intend to teach Kenpachi Zaraki Zanjutsu. Captain Kuchika and the others went to the Royal Palace, but there are no guarantee they'll return safely. Kenpachi is an important asset in battle. Have you forgotten we urged Genryusai to stop teaching him Kendo only after a day? Yeah, well, what do you suggest to do in this current state? You guys literally got bodied. You gotta take some risks somewhere, you know? Central 46 have never been known as, like, a good government at all. Seems like I've been given permission. Yeah, silence is golden, as Kage would once say. If you'd like to handle the matter concerning Captain Zaraki, Who's this? Unohana? What? Why is Captain Unohana here? Or should I say, the first Kenpachi? What? Yachiru Unohana, let's go! Look at these chuckle fox. Oh, Khan? Hello, Khan. Oh, the beeping. Buff Khan! Let's go! Let's go, Buff Khan. We love to see it. Okay, we got one of our things. We got one of our comedies, boys. They're just going to ignore it as well. Ooh, here we go. Can we get our Shokugeki no Soma on with this food detail? Look at that. Yeah. Meat's looking good. Egg fried rice looking good. It's looking nice, man. Is that a burger? That's a tall ass burger. Can you even eat, fam? Yeah, that's a big-ass burger. Look at that ramen there in the back. There's no way she'd serve us this food for no reason. I bet it's an excuse to start some ridiculous form of training. Seems like you grew up distrustful thanks to Kisuke. My job is to ensure your bellies are full. But is it just normal food, though? Khan, why are you chomping down, bruv? You ain't fighting, bro. Damn, man's got the noodles. Damn, look at these. I mean, it ain't no Goku. But they be packing it away. I'll go make dessert. Have you seen how much man's eating? Khan, you... How are you eating, fam? What's going on?
Hey, it's nice to see Ichigo and Renji happy. It really is.
And the way the awesome aroma spreads throughout. We're really getting on our soma right now. That's crazy. The artwork so far has been amazing too. Everything's been on point, on model, what I expected. Comedy's been there. Really loving this episode so far. The voice change? Voice change? Who's this? Oogity boogity boys! That's right! It's no different than getting ready for other training. Yes, sir! Literally us boys. You gonna explain why you're thin? Shit! To my animated friends, whoever did that, thank you. It's a bit weird that Ichigo's Ishihakusho like heals the stronger your spiritual pressure is, right? So it's like, why is the arm not generated? I guess it's because the Bankai is broken, right? And those who are recognized as being the history of the Soul Society itself by the Soul King are allowed to join our squad. What I've created was a temporary soul and the technology to place it into a body. Con! The concept of the Gikon. Did not exist until I created a temporary soul, and part of that concept was applied to create soul candies. Con! The essence of Gikon is to increase one's level of power by placing a completely foreign spiritual pressure into your own body. The food you ate was filled with that essence. Your body should be containing spiritual pressure that is nothing like you felt before. The one in the next place is totally unpredictable. Are we gonna see Oetsu's harem? He's the man who created Zanpacto. Let's go. And what I add with these as well, that in the last episode, we was given stuff about Zabimaru and Ikkaku's Azukimaru, but it was in the total cards. So if there's any complaints, I'm going to hold off on some things because it might be in the total card. So that's unfortunate that they don't get translated, but it is what it is. The Central Underground Great Prison. Pog? Who's this in? Kenpachi Zaraki. Hey, looks clean, looks clean. He healed up really quickly for a guy that was apparently supposed to be incapacitated, you know? Okay, this is an interesting... That's the entranceway, right? This is rather grandioso stage, is it not? Infinitely large. Yes. So why is there walls? It's probably because it's the entranceway. Interesting, like, look to it, though, for sure. Like, those, like, crystal pillars. Da! Menacing! Menacing! You have no power! I suggest this place because I felt you would fit here perfectly. I like you better when you're quiet. Sheesh, come on. Ooh, the scar! We finally see the scar! After all these years, if you haven't played BBS, you finally see the scar of why she wears the braids in front. And Kenpachi's scar. Hey, come on! Ah, they're gonna cut away from it! Once you and Captain Zaraki cross blades, one of you will have to die. Who says that? I guess it's a Kenpachi like rule type of thing, maybe. Hey, that's an inch. Yeah, interesting lighting to Isane. Ah, no, she. Yeah, we're gonna see Yatru for the first time, other than the opening. Hey, there's Yatru. Hey. This looks different. Oh, damn. We're really getting into this fight a little bit. This is really dark. Like, the lighting's dark. And that's my only complaint with it. Hey, but the martial arts, so come on. Okay, it should end here, right? With their fight. But even if you remove it, that's the extent of your power. Ooh, damn, man. Unohana ain't messing about. She ain't rusty. She might be. Who knows? Ooh, the disrespect. I can't believe someone swinging a sword with one arm wouldn't even make use of their own other arm. True. To think you'd resort to using a cheap trick like this to wound me. Oh, damn. Kenpachi getting bodied. Oh, I like the detail on his sword there, though. Really? Oh, this is longer than I expected it to be. You haven't changed at all. Oh, is she going to do it? I have the leeway to use cheap tricks against you. That I've gotten weaker? Yes. Yes, you have gotten weaker, my guy. Are we going to get a flashback? Interesting. They're moving things around. Okay. Like the blood effects, though. Hey, young Kenpachi! Fighting you was the first time I felt fear. I like the POV shot there. I wanted to fight just like you. I mean, I'm asking too much, but I was hoping we get a little bit of a skirmish between young and old. Am I ever going to die without beating you? Hey, ah, oh, damn. Man's crying. You know when this man's crying that it's serious, man. because that's his limiter. Unohana is his limiter. Ooh. And we're back. What happened there? What's all this about then? You look like you spaced out for a moment. I hope this explains it so much better in the manga, in the anime than it did the manga. You will not die. Each time you're on the verge of death, you grow stronger. True. Really? We ending it there? My sin. Interesting. Okay. Wow, really blew my expectations. Battle is everything. Oh, that's beautiful poem. The battle, episode 10. Right, so that was our episode 9 of Bleach the Thousand Year Blood War. I am extremely surprised by this because I generally didn't think that we're going to use this until maybe the last minute to kind of gas up episode 10 a little bit and then spend the majority of episode 10 on Kenpachi versus Unohana, which can still be the case. You know, you can still have a fight and then the backstory. But I was really expecting Ichigo and Renji with Namaya Uetsu. So this really threw me in for a bit of a loop. And did they move things around? Potentially, I have to go check. But yeah, again, I really enjoyed this episode and it surprised me more than I thought in so many different ways. And the lighting of the Mukan, it's an interesting one because I've got a bunch of lights hitting me right now. So like I was finding it a little bit difficult to see, but it hit really well. From what I can see. So I expect really some big things for episode 10. I don't know why, but I have a feeling, I have a hunch. So I'm very excited for that. And chances are we're going to get Namaya as well next episode. Because that would only make sense. I mean, you wouldn't go into everything but the rain for like 11, 12 and 13. I would imagine it's going to start around about the halfway point of episode 11. So, but yeah, you wouldn't. The way that they've got to do it means that Namaya has to come in at episode 10. So I'm very interested. It's really throwing me in for a little bit of a loop. But I really enjoyed this episode. Kenpachi versus Unohana. It's starting off. Coming clutch. Hopefully it explains the fight a little bit better than the manga did. I know that there's going to be a few added things in regards to like abilities. So hopefully that will give us a lot more clarity in what actually happened during that stabbing through the neck and then being okay. So I mean, if you play BBS, it kind of somewhat gives you an idea of what happened. But overall, lovely episode. Enjoyed this. Definitely exciting one to talk about. So if you like this live reaction or if you want to hear my full thoughts, I will do a review as always. So click the like and subscribe and have the notifications on as well, because again, it helps a lot. So that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.